What's up, guys? It is Carly here, bringing you day 15 of my 31 days of horror, and today I'm going to be talking about kind of a random film, and that is Silent Night, Deadly Night, Part 3, from the year 1989. Now, you're probably wondering why I'm talking about a Christmas movie in the middle of October, and it's simply because it's been on my to-watch stack for almost a year now, because JP and I were supposed to do a review of this one and on his channel for his 12 days of Christmas, and we just didn't give each other enough time and we failed to finish it. We did do Silent Night Part 1 and 2, but that was it. So I've just had this one as well as 3 and, as well as 4 and 5 sitting on my stack for the longest time, and I figured I might as well go ahead and watch them now. I was just curious about them all this time, and I figured, why not? Silent Night, Deadly Night 3, the plot here is you have this girl, Laura. She is blind, and she is working in this facility, sort of a hospital, to help this doctor reach the mind of Ricky from the previous films. Ricky, his life has been saved, but he is in a coma, and his brain is, like, in this glass container on top of his head, and it's really weird, but the doctor is trying to get this girl to, just get inside Ricky's mind and maybe wake him up or see what's going on in there and stuff like that. She usually only can do this while sleeping, and, yeah, that's kind of her power there. One night, she goes home for Christmas with her brother and her brother's girlfriend. They're going to their grandparents' house because I believe their parents have actually both passed away. So they're going to their grandma's house. It's kind of their tradition. And Ricky actually wakes up and sets out to find Laura. So that's what's going on here. Of course, I've heard nothing but bad things about this movie. So going into it, I was really kind of dreading this one, especially because the main bad thing I had heard was that it is very slow and boring, and I will say it is pretty slow and not a lot is going on in it, but I will also say, and here's where people will think I am mental and not go along with my opinion at all, but I was not really bored by this one. I actually was kind of interested in the story just simply because it's still trying to go along with the Silent Night, Deadly Nights storyline, whatever that may be. Obviously Part 2's not even that great of a film, it's just for comedy's sake, but this one is trying to go along with that, with this Ricky character, and you even still get flashbacks from Part 1, and I just find it interesting because it's nothing really like Part 1 and 2. It doesn't really have a strong Christmas vibe or anything, and you're following a totally different type of character in this, but I just thought it was cool that they did at least attempt to go along with the storyline, whatever that may be, I say again, and yeah, but this movie is, like I said, definitely slow. Bill Moseley plays the Ricky character, but it might as well just be any typical dude, because all he does is whisper Laura and walk around aimlessly, because obviously his brain is fried, so it's not like a great Bill Moseley performance or anything. Like I said, it could just be any dude could have worked for this part, good actor or not, so that's kind of disappointing, but this was one of his earlier films, so yeah, what can you really do? I almost feel like this movie gets confused on what character they're supposed to be following, which brother, because the flashbacks you're seeing are of Billy from the first movie. It's mainly just showing him, and it's not showing little Ricky as a baby. So I was actually confused while watching it, and I even looked it up to make sure I wasn't the one who was mixing up the characters. But no, this is supposed to be Ricky, who obviously is the star of Part 2. This obviously doesn't look anything like him, but oh well. Like I said, this movie doesn't have a great Christmas vibe or anything like the first two do, or at least the first one does, but I will say when they do get to the grandma's house, there's a bit of a Christmas flow going on that I appreciate. Her house is all decked out for the holidays, and it's kind of cozy and also kind of eerie. I do like up until when they first get to the grandma's house. I was actually pretty into the movie, which is, that's probably the first 45 minutes, I would say. This is a 90-minute film, and then once they're at the grandma's house, that's kind of where I start to get a little bit taken out of the film. I wouldn't say I'm bored completely. I was still interested in what was going to happen, but I definitely see why people find it tedious to get through, because once you're at that point, not a whole lot happens, and your main killer dude in this movie is just this slow-walking guy who's saying Lori, and there's really not much to him, so that's not all that entertaining. I do like the characters, though. I actually did like the Laura character. I thought she did a decent job, and I didn't mind the brother and his girlfriend character either, to be completely honest, so yeah, I don't know. I didn't completely hate this movie like literally everyone else in the world does. I've never heard anyone say anything good about this, but I kind of went in expecting nothing, and I guess I got a little bit of something out of it, at least. I'm not saying it's fantastic. It's not a great sequel to, like I said, the Silent Night, Deadly Night movie, but it's not the worst thing I've ever seen in my life. I'm still not going to give it a huge high rating. I give it a average 5 out of 10. Once again, people probably think that's kind of ridiculous for this film, but I think I was just so surprised by how much I didn't hate it that I could give it that fair rating. So 5 out of 10 for Silent Night, Deadly Night Part 3. Thank you guys once again for joining me for day 15, and I will see you for day 16.